Alright, so now I can actually shoot back at those archers up there. I think I can get some really long-range shots. There's airdrop in this game? Well, I thought there was. Maybe there's actually not. Oh, there's not. I think at really long ranges there is, if I'm not mistaken. Because there's some kind of challenge for, like, shooting an arrow, like, across the entire Kakariko village or something. And that one's hampered a little bit by... Well, it was hampered for me because I was playing on the Wii. And aiming the Wii remote for arrows is cool and all. But it does have a certain degree of difficulty to it. Because your hand wobbles a little bit. And at that range, that, you know, causes you to be way off. Oh man, let's see if I can grab those arrows. Kind of wondering what the max size of my wallet is. I've been told it's bigger, which it obviously is, but I don't know how much it is. It feels like it might be 400, but I'm not sure. Okay, what is this way? It's like a wraparound path? It doesn't look like it actually goes anywhere. Ah, yes. Okay, that is. So it just takes me up to the upper level. I think those are explosives! But luckily, you guys are idiots too! Oh, and you can collect the enemy's arrows? I forgot about that. I mean, not a lot of enemies shoot arrows. In fact, I'm pretty sure that is the only enemy that shoots arrows, that enemy type. But still, you know, something. Yeah, so we have to make a magnificent upside down arrow shot while on the moving magnet. Which I think is a pretty good culmination of everything we've done thus far. Oh, there's a chest down there. We can't leave yet. Also a strange piece of piping over here. Or a barrel or something. Quick, let's hurry up before we drowned! Oh, dang it, another stamp. Should be another treasure chest in this direction, it's telling me. But, like, up there, so I'm gonna have to figure out how to get up there. Does the magnet reach all the way down here? I don't think it does. I was hoping to kind of cheap it out and get it on the sweep when it comes over here or something. Nope, gotta make our way back up. They did give us a lovely ladder, thank you! Let me see if there's anything else I'm missing. Not that I really want to go back for it. Other than that one I've just already seen. The compass is in fact telling me that there's nothing I've missed thus far. Cool. I think when the bridge falls, it'll allow me to get that one treasure I'm looking at. You guys ready for more disorienting? Look at Link's hat. There you go. And that's actually going to be my landing platform as well. You can just tell there was a lot of work put into these iron boot items, and that's cool. There's an item up there. How do I get up there? I don't think that magnet gets me into a position where I can. Oh, well. I would have preferred to bottle that, but thanks, I guess. Oh, I'm starting to... I feel like I'm gonna have to come back later for that one. That's actually looking kind of likely now. So is there seriously... No, wait, there might be another... There might be another fairy coming up. Let me, switch out to an empty bottle so I can grab it quickly if I do see one. For real? Come on. Alright, let's get some range. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, I think there was an item in this game that allows you to, like, get a scope or something weird for your bow? I know it sounds weird, but I think that was a thing. It's been so long, I don't even know. Go. It sounds weird me saying it, but I feel like that's definitely a thing. If that bridge was up, how did all these enemies get inside? Silly game, truly. Well, the starter wallet definitely holds more than 400, I can say that. Don't do this to me, game. No. I've only got one milk left. I don't know if I can do this. Alright, let's go. Maybe it'll go okay. Maybe there won't be any issues whatsoever. Maybe I won't die. Awakens the dark creature. Oh, yeah, it awakens and catches on fire. Twilight Igniter Virus. Let's see if I can remember how to do this one. Not that way. Not that way. Hey, Minda, you got any ideas? Did you see his forehead? Oh, yeah, we had to shoot that first. I'm sensing some powerful magic coming out of that shining spot in his forehead. Surely your garden variety arrows can deal with that kind of deal. I think that incapacitates him for a little bit. Now all we have to do is trip him. I think I may have waited too long. Oh, no, no. There we go. Oh, no! Let's move in for the kill, Link. Let's get that milk out. Let's go ahead and drink it preemptively, just in case. That's all we got. Mad bro? You mad? Oh no, foiled again by the same plan. Moving in for the kill. A lot easier to aim actually than I think it was on the Wii. Let me go. That actually went really well and like fairly easy, especially compared to the first boss battle I did. Didn't exactly use any massive things other than, you know, shoot him with a bow and then use your heavy boots to pull on his legs. I can't tell if we killed him or not. Like if he's like for real dead or if we just purified the evil or, you know, something equally as happy. I think we just purified the evil. Hee hee hee, well done.
What would die?
Now we have two few shadows.
And what was
you know, you've been very helpful so far. So as a reward, I'll tell you an interesting story. Zant. That's the name of the King of Darkness who cast this pale of shadows over your world. He's very strong. You would be nothing to him in your current state. But Zant will never be my king. I've nothing but scorn for his supposed strength. Not that your Zelda is much better. It still appalls me that this world of light is controlled by that princess. A carefree youth. A life of luxury. How does that teach duty? But I guess I shouldn't begrudge her the circumstances of her life. She didn't choose it after all, and I would never wish harm on her. No, as long as I can get my hand on the few shadows, I'll be just fine. Well, just one more left, shall we? Hehe. Yeah, don't forget your heart piece. And I'm feeling less evil today. Look at me, so ecstatic. Oh, God. I love hearts. That's going to help out a lot. What am I doing here? My head, it aches. We're just gonna leave you to that. Wanna go outside? Yep, we're all done. And now, actually, that milk's gonna be even less useful because I have 6 hearts. I mean, it's still moderately useful, but a potion's gonna, I think, be a little bit more what I need before long.
Thank you.
heroic Mr. 250. Yes, that is my name. North of here, across the plain and past the great stone bridge, in the lands guarded by the spirit Lanaru? You shall find the one you seek. Thanks. That's probably really weird, wasn't it? I just kind of teleported out of nowhere. Mr. 250! Ilya. You've got to save Ilya. Or Leah, or something. I don't know. I still don't know her name. Those monsters left me with the other kids. But they must have taken her somewhere else. Whenever I thought I couldn't go on, I would think of you and Ilya and hold on, Mr. 250. I can't let romantic interest get away. See, I'm fine now. Remember what I told you back in Ordon, Mr. 250? When I grow up, I'm gonna be just like you. So you don't have to worry about me anymore. Go help Ilya. I would worry severely about anyone doing what I'm trying to do. Leave the children to me. I will watch over them, I swear it. Do not let their fates trouble you. Go to those who need you. In Hyrule, countless tales are told of the ancient hero, and your deeds bring them all to mind. May the graces of the great goddesses who shaped Hyrule bear you on your way. Come on, kid, bow. Bow to me! Kids these days can't even respect their elders. So yeah, now the Gorons are okay with us. And I want to take a look around, because I think this is when some stuff starts to, like, open up a bit. A little bit. There's not... This town doesn't open up a lot, but I think it opens up a little bit. And I actually don't remember what all does, so I'm going to just take kind of a look around. Because I got a little time as of yet. There's a bug in here. I didn't know there's a bug. Cool. That'll be useful for later. We are very grateful for you for saving our chief and our precious mines, brother. We caused a lot of trouble for the people of this town. It is our turn to repay them. Hey, brother, climb on my back and I will launch you up to the hotel's hot spring. Wow, really? I didn't know you did that. Okay, cool, yeah. Let's just get sent off into space, why don't we? You didn't really launch me. I thought I was going to land in the hot spring. Not nearly as cool as I thought. You are creepy. Oh, good warm soak is just what my muscles need before evening falls, brother. I sell stuff across from the bomb shop at night. I hope to see you there, brother. Do you really? You saved our chief, brother, and we are thankful. Now we are able to come back down to the village again. Since this town was also attacked, I figured the townsfolk would need supplies. So, my son and I brought some things down, brother. At night, my son opens up a shop down below. You should stop by sometime, brother. I might actually just do that. There's also a Goron over there. He sells stuff right here. So we're gonna check back later for that. Now that we're able to go back into our mines, I was finally able to bring Barnes a new delivery of bomb ingredients, brother. It looks like he's already started selling them again. You should try out Barnes brand bombs sometimes, brother. Say, brother, if you ever want to get under the roof of the store, I can launch you up there. What do you say to that? Not right now, thanks though. If you ever do want to go up top, I will launch you up there. Shortcuts. I didn't know they actually did that. Maybe they did in the original game too. And I just never bothered to check. Sell me some bombs. Hey now, bud. How about this? Yep, I finally managed to get my numbers together and open up shop again. Well, sort of. I've only got one other type of bomb. One type of bomb, but hey, that's more than none, right? If only my storehouse had survived. But hey, ain't as bad as all that. I'll add more types as we go. For now, you have the look-see. Let's buy some bombs. I mean, you got a bomb bag for carrying bombs, huh? I've got a special offer going right now. My bomb bag premium kit. Which comes with a bag and bombs. 120 rupees. How about that? So you're selling me. What is he? He's selling these for 30. So he's literally selling a bag for holding bombs for 90. Now, and I don't imagine that a bomb bag necessarily has to be anything like really, really fancy. Like, it is a bag for holding bombs. He is selling them for, what is that? 3 times the price of the bombs? That's right. Now you get to taste the true height of perfection with my finely crafted bombs. Oh, and you can combine bombs and arrows to make bomb arrows for when you need to make ranged explosives. I'll send you a letter with the details later. We're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You know, for the people who need bombs at 3 in the morning. I locked myself out of my car. Can I have a bomb? So yeah, as they stated, there is a ability to... How do you do it in this? I'm not quite sure. I'll have to look at that later, but there's an ability to do bomb arrows, which is actually kind of a neat thing. It does obviously consume one of both to use, but it does allow you to throw bombs much farther away. So I just need to figure out how to do that. Bow and arrow combo. I put it over there? Oh. That's weird. That goes on to, like, ZL. That is an odd thing. I guess it's okay. Also, they'll explode if you have them held for too long. Alright, and let's, that. Oops. Wrong button. You got a piece of heart. Ah, chicken. That's where you're at. I think we actually need these guys if we want to get certain things. We'll come back for you later, chickens. You just chill out there. Don't move a muscle. Anyway, we can get to the back of the spring. Which has a treasure located down here. I think that's the only real thing down here. But it's cool. Got another piece of heart. It's racking them up. Oh, there is a rock down here, which might have something else in it. But we can't actually use these bombs underwater, the ones we have, so we're kind of stuck on that one for now. Anyway, let me grab that chicken. I'm pretty sure he's an integral part of, like, getting another chest or something. But to tell you the truth, I don't remember exactly how this goes. I think you have to use the ramps in this town to, like, give yourself enough ground to actually... Like, not have to go inside buildings, because you can't take chicken in buildings. Yeah, I definitely remember there being chickens somewhere in the town, but I never found them, so I was like, where do you go? But I think this is how you do it. This chicken's so mad. Thank you. So there was that chest quite a while ago I was trying to get. And this is how you get it. Oh crap. I was supposed to jump on those platforms. Come back, chicken! Oh, landed on a well-placed rock. Chicken, can you come down here? I'm gonna need you. Actually, if he stays up there, I might be able to get back anyway. Here, send me up, brother. Wow. Do it again. Let's aim for more the middle of the roof this time. There we go. Now, if we're lucky, the chicken will still be up on that slope. And then I can just get him with the boomerang. Because I think you can pull chickens with the wind boomerang. Where is he at? Oh, he fell down. I don't know. I don't want me... Midna, I'm trying to deal with chickens right now. Get out of my face. See him. Oh, you think you're a smart devil, don't you? Oh boy, you're about to have a rude awakening. Go! Okay. I wonder. Can he throw me up and then I can get the chicken even higher with the boomerang? Chicken, come back! When I grow up, I want to be just like you, Mr. 250. Maybe you'll be restating that when you see that Mr. 250 moonlights as Chicken Man, who saves the world by flying around from rooftop to rooftop on a chicken. Alright, this is the final strategy. Let's see if this works. Oh, this is not looking good. Oh, you can walk in that. Okay, cool. Get out of here, loser chicken. I don't want you anymore. Look at him. And he's just okay. I thought that was going to be a heart piece, to be honest. Alright, anyway, I think that's going to be it for now. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. And I will end up seeing you next time. No, brother. No thanks. I will see you next time for some more Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. Bye!